sent his son. They called him Jesus. He came to
guys, you're gonna be out with the lead guitar today.
Blew an amp, I guess. All right, let's go.
Mm-hmm.
We live for you. We live for you. Jesus, the name above every other name. Jesus, the only one who could ever save. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you. We live for you. Devil's Den. Spirit break down, break our walls down. Spirit break down, oh, heaven come down. Spirit break down. Break down. Ringo was Danner. Spirit breakdown. Heaven come down. Thank you, Jesus.
Stone was rolled away. His perfect love could die.
Jesus.
I am.
Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for this morning, Lord, and for this church, Lord. I thank you for them and for this team I have up here on stage, Lord. I just thank you for them. Just so humbled by your presence, Lord. I thank you for what you're doing in our lives, Lord, loving us when we don't deserve it. I pray for all those out here today that are struggling with anything, Lord, that you set us all free, Lord. I thank you for what you do. In Jesus' name, and everyone said, no doubt.
Buckle up and hold on. At our church, we love God. Make no mistake about that. At our church, we believe in God's radical, unconditional, and unwavering love for us. At our church, we believe that Jesus is God. We also affirm that you may or may not believe that Jesus is God. And we're not asking you to change your belief system before you attend our church. We're simply inviting you on a journey toward Jesus. For years, churches have placed a high priority on Jesus as the get-out-of-hell-free card. At our church, we place the highest priority on Jesus as a live-life-to-the-fullest invitation. At our church, we believe every person has a dream deep inside their hearts, and that God put that dream there, not for our glory, but for His. At our church, we're not concerned with where you've been, but where you're going. At our church, we believe that the Bible is God's Word. It is real. It is living. It is active. We believe that people who don't go to church anywhere are not the enemy. They are real people who need the perfect love that only God can give. And we believe that God gives this love through, of all people, us. At our church, we do not and we will not display a holier-than-thou attitude toward anyone. We are all broken people. But He is putting us back together. And finally, and most importantly, at our church, we believe that Jesus really lived, that He really died on the cross, and that He really rose again on the third day. And we cannot and we will not candy coat or water down that message, ever. Today, you've chosen to sit yourself in the middle of a very safe place to hear a potentially dangerous message. Welcome to our church.
Good morning. Welcome to Freedom Biker Church, York, PA. My name is Jim Quose. I'm the preacher, and I am free, no doubt. Hey, man, it's been a week, right? It's been a day, right? Sometimes it's like that, right? But you know what? God is with us, right? Amen. You can feel I can feel His Spirit here today, Lord, and despite everything that's been going on. He's with us, man, and He's working us through it, and we're going to get through it because we're going to stay focused on Him, man. Amen? Pray with me. Lord Jesus, we just acknowledge You as the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. No matter what happens, no matter what we come up against, You're greater than everything that comes against us. You're greater than He that is within this world. We have victory in You, Lord, and we acknowledge that and thank You for that today. We worship You, Lord. We love You. Holy Spirit, we can feel Your presence. I just pray that You would work through me and through the words that I say, Lord, that You would deliver Your message to Your people, and they would receive it today, Lord, and that it would encourage them, it would lift them up, Lord, and it would transform their lives so they could become who You have created them to be. Lord, I just pray that Your love would be felt throughout this church and outside of its walls, Lord, as we leave today. And Lord, I just will be careful to give You all the praise and all the glory for all You say and all You do in Jesus' name. And everyone said,
no doubt.
So hey to everybody. Hey to the gallery back there. All right. Hey to everybody on Facebook Live, man. We get a lot of people that check us out there and appreciate that. And we're so glad that we can get our message and our church out there so everybody can enjoy it, man. It's a great family. I love this church. Have I told you guys that, man? I love this church. I don't want to neglect to say, please keep the Jarhead MC in prayer. They were in a really, there was a really tragic accident up north. Truck ran into a group of motorcycles, at least seven people dead, several people in the hospital. Pray for their family, man. Pray for that club. Pray for just all the people there, okay? Keep them in your prayers. Would you please stand for the pledge? I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Amen. Okay, we have a dedication today. So, if we could bring the youngsters up here to be dedicated. Hey, man, come on up.
Hello. He's waiting.
Oh, he's waiting. He is. Hey, man.
How you doing?
Hey, Steve. Nice to meet you. All right, so we have Steve and Summer here, and we have Ron. Which one's Ronnie? This is little Ronnie. And Killian. Ron and Killian. And look, what we're going to do is, as a church family, we're going to pray over these children and dedicate them to Jesus and commit to help in any way we can to raise them and teach them to walk with the Lord. Amen? Okay, so would you guys just pray with me as I bless this family and bless these children. Lord Jesus, we just thank you for who you are and all you do, Lord. And man, we just thank you for these newest members of our church family, Lord. And Lord, I just pray for Steve and Summer as they raise these children, Lord, that you would just give them strength, lead, guide, and direct them, and just help them to raise these children in your way, Lord, to raise them the right way, Lord, raise them the best way so that they can become what you've created them to be. Bless Ron and Killian in their lives, Lord. Lord, we commit as a church to do everything in our power to help this family, to help these children, and lead, guide, and direct them in the way of the Lord. And Lord, we love you, Jesus, and we just pray that this family will feel your presence in a great and mighty way as they go, as they walk through this journey together. We're so grateful for them. We're so grateful for the new life, Lord, and the healthy children. And Lord, we just can't thank you and love you enough for who you are and all you do. And we pray these things in Jesus' mighty name. And everyone said, amen. No doubt.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you very much.
Not a problem, buddy. Hey, did you hear the fan? I have a fan. All right. So that's, man, I love doing that kind of stuff, right? I mean, baby, we have another thing that I love doing today is a wedding. Yeah, Mike and Deb are getting married today. It's going to be outside because it's a beautiful day. And we're just doing the wedding here. There's no reception. But if you're staying, that's great. If you're not staying, go take a ride. I'm not telling you you got to go, but get out of here, okay? We have the car and bike show. I believe that's been rescheduled for June 30th, if I'm correct, but we'll check on that. As always, we're always looking for help in Chopper Church. So if you have a heart for children and children's ministry, talk to Deb Hauer, and she can get you set up for that. Also, I wanted to point out that our own Ransom Souls is going to be playing Creation this week. Yeah. Creation is Thursday through Saturday. Wednesday, I'm sorry. I'm going Thursday, so I'm not worried about Wednesday. No, Wednesday through Saturday. And Crowder's playing on Thursday, so I'm not worried about Wednesday. Wednesday through Saturday, man. And I got to brag to people all the time. Yeah, our band plays at Creation. I mean, they're great. We know they're great, but it's just so awesome that they get to. So if you get any opportunity, man, please go up and see them and support them. You know, and just hey, and if you have a great opportunity to share Jesus with a whole, probably thousands of people, okay? So if you get a chance, do that. Let's see. Oh, yeah, one more. Bike night June 28th at Bald Hills Distillery, 6 to 11 p.m. This is for LJ, to benefit LJ. LJ recently had a was a liver transplant, and he's doing pretty well. But of course, you know, with that comes bills and medical bills and all kinds of things to take care of. And you know, we just want to love on him and his family and friends. So if you get a chance, support that. At this time, we're ready to take our offering. As I say every week, there's no cover charge here at Freedom Biker Church. But if you like what's going on here and you want to support this ministry, you'd like to see a bunch of other churches like this that people can go to and God's put it on your heart, then this is your opportunity to do so. Look, I'm going to play a video. I got to say, it's Crowder. Yeah. I love Crowder, you know that. And he does it at the Melrose Billiards Club. So it's Crowder in a pool hall. So when I saw it, I said, this is the perfect storm, man. I have got to play this video. So I hope you guys enjoy it as much as I did.
All right. Is there anybody sunshine been turned to rain? Is there anybody's blue sky been turned to gray? Is there anybody's good time turned out real bad? Is there anyone's happiness turned out sad? And I know I can't trust in the things that I see.
I don't care what you say, man. That dude is cool. And it ain't just a beard and long hair. You know what I'm saying? Guys is talented. How to overcome the world. So I just want to start out by saying sometimes when I'm putting together my sermon or trying to get an idea of what God wants me to talk about, I get all the way till the end of the week and I'm still not sure. You know, and I sit down and I start reading and I start looking at things and I see something and I seen this message and I said, is this really what I'm supposed to talk about? You know, I have my own doubts, you know. This is how God works, though. You know, we say, is God speaking? I don't hear God. Where's God in all this? And he's right there, right? It's not him that's not there. It's us that we're not sure. It's not that he's not sure. We have our doubts. It's not that he doubts. We say, are you sure? This is what you want me to do. And after some of the things that have happened this week and some of the people that I've talked to, I'm sure this is what God wants to talk about today. How to overcome the world. Abraham Lincoln wrote in his diary during the worst part of the Civil War at the height, and believe me, I've read Abraham Lincoln's biography. If you ever get a chance, read Abraham Lincoln's biography. He was an amazing man, and he loved God, and he loved our country, and he went through some of the worst turmoil any president has ever seen then and since. And during the height of all that, he said this, without Christ, I cannot succeed. But with Christ, I cannot fail. Right? Yeah. We get in them situations, right? We're in that place where we feel like, I can't succeed. How am I going to get through this? And the answer is always the same. With Jesus. I can't do it without him, but with him I can't fail. And we got to know that, man, and we got to grab a hold of that. That's all we got in those situations, right? That's the hope that we have is with him we can't fail. With him we can't lose. With him we have victory. With him we can get through anything. And with him, we will get through even this life. Close our eyes and open our eyes in the arms of Jesus. Even death will not prevail over us through Jesus Christ. Amen. Here's a quote by R.A. Torrey, and it says, the reason why many the reason why many fail in battle is because they wait until the hour of the battle. The reason why others succeed is because they have gained their victory on their knees long before the battle came. Hear that word. Anticipate your battles. Fight them on your knees before temptation comes, and you will always have victory. That spoke to me, right? Because that's what I do. I don't proact, I react, right? I wait until things get, you know, things are good and, you know, I go along and I pray, you know, our Father who art in heaven, blah, 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 blah. You know, I do my devotions sometimes, right? And everything's good and everything's cool. And then comes the battle. Then something happens. Or as I'll say, all hell breaks loose. literally. Satan comes against you. Fear attacks. We feel beaten down. Then we grab our gun. Right? Now we want to practice. Now we want to learn how to fight. Now we want God to come alongside of us. Now we want to join forces. Right? We need to do that ahead of time, folks. We need to, the time to prepare for the battle is long before the battle. Right? Don't get me wrong, man. If you got yourself caught in a battle that you weren't expecting or you weren't prepared for, God is still with you. What I'm saying is we can make it much easier on ourselves. Because if we're already walking with God, if we are already close to Jesus, when the battle starts, He's there. We don't have to look for Him. We don't have to draw close to Him. He's already beside us. Right? We don't have to call in the troops. The troops are there. Prepare ahead of time. When these bad things happen, then it's either what? Fight or flight. Right? So at that moment, again, we either draw close to God, we draw close to Jesus, or we start running away and pushing Him away. Right? And as we push Him away, things get worse. And as things get worse, now we decide we want to call on Him. Now we want Him to come back, but, you know, there's already been a lot of damage done. And look, God's not trying to hurt us. We live in a depraved world. We're depraved people. All the suffering and the pain is a result of all that. It's not something that God willed upon us or wished upon us. Right? Here we were in paradise, and then here was outside of paradise. And God wanted us here in paradise with Him. We're the ones that decided we wanted to do this on our own. That's true, right? Do you do? I do it all the time. I got this. I don't want to live in your protection. I don't want to follow. I don't want to do the things that you want me to do because I want to do the things I want to do. So I'm going to live out here in the world. I'm not going to live in the kingdom where I should be living. Right? And then when the bad things happen, I say, well, God, where are you? And He says, I'm right here, man. He cast us out of the garden. When He cast us out of the garden, we were separated from all the protection, all the paradise, all the great things that He had for us because we made a conscious decision that that's not the way we wanted to live. And we've been paying, we paid the price for that until the day Jesus Christ hung on that cross and spilled His blood for us, died, was buried, and was resurrected and defeated sin and death. So now God is inviting us back to the garden. Come back to the kingdom. Not just after death, but right now, here on earth as in heaven. But you got to be with me, man. Yeah, accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, but you have to follow. You have to be all in all the time. It's hard to do, isn't it? This is how John describes the victory and our power to overcome this world. He says in 1 John 5:4-5, for everyone born of God overcomes the world. This is the victory that has overcome the world, even our faith. Who is it that overcomes the world? Only the one that believes that Jesus is the Son of God. It's only one way to overcome this world. And that's through Jesus Christ. That's through putting our faith and trust in Him. God gave us a way to reconcile our relationship that had been destroyed, that had been that we thought were was lost. It's much like life, right? When we go through these struggles, we think we're done. We think it's over. I've been there. Man, this, how am I going to work this out? I'm not. But if I put my faith and trust in Jesus Christ, God is with me, the Holy Spirit is with me, and when I have done that, things start to turn around. As I felt like I'm lost, as I felt like I'm losing, as I feel like I'm failing, now all of a sudden, I start to see hope. I start to see a light. I start to see things turning around. I start to see victory. And when I get there and I look back at the pain and the suffering and everything I've been through, I see that God had a plan for me. God had a purpose for me. And it was way better than anything I could have imagined or wanted for myself. We have to trust God. We have to trust Jesus. So I won't lie to you. I mean, people that don't believe or trust in Jesus, they win some of the battles, right? We see them and they look like they're doing all right. Well, I mean, they don't listen. They don't obey. It seems like they're doing okay or things go pretty good. Looks like they're having a pretty good time, right? There's a lot of things that we do. Look, you know, I don't care if you drink a beer. I don't even think it's a sin, right? But I will tell you this, that I drank a lot, and I partied a lot, and I felt like I was really having a good time, and then I felt the consequences of that. Sometimes the next day, right? Sometimes years later. It affected my health. I had a heart attack. I have diabetes. I have high blood pressure. It's not because God gave me those things. It's because I drank a lot, I smoked a lot, I ate a lot of things I shouldn't eat, I didn't take care of myself. I was having a good time, right? But I paid a price. We all do, right? Do you guys remember where you were when during the 9/11 attacks? I do. I can remember, you know, I can't remember what I had for breakfast, right? But I can remember conversations I had that day. I can remember the first time I watched those planes flying into the towers, right? We remember those things. It's easy to become bitter and angry over things that happen like that. You know, it's easy to focus on all the tragedy and it's in times like that it would be easy to just give up, right? It would be easy to just say, you know, I can't do this anymore. It's just too terrible. The world's just such a terrible place. It makes it hard to overcome. Frankly, I don't know how people get through life and get through tragedies and get through all this pain and suffering without Jesus. I don't know how they do it. Because it's hard. It's hard with Jesus, right? I can't imagine how they do it without him. I don't know how they get through it, but I know that when people don't know Jesus, when people don't follow Jesus, when people rely on their own strength, it usually doesn't turn out well. I see them, they're a mess. They don't know, where are you going to turn? Where's your hope? Who are you going to rely on? Look, man, we are not God. We are not gods, right? We can't overcome on our own. Our own strength is no strength. We're a grain of sand in the history of the world. Otherwise insignificant. Otherwise powerless. Only through Jesus are we given the strength, because at that moment we become filled with the Holy Spirit, and we are part of the Almighty. Now, instead of being a grain of sand, we are part of He who created all the grains of sand. We become part of His family. It's where we get our strength to overcome the things that happen in this world. How can we become, when bad things happen, when tragedies are going on, when it seems like our whole world is falling apart, when it feels like hell is actually coming against us, how can we do better rather than being bitter? Being bitter and staying bitter will never help you to overcome. You might be mad at God, and it's okay to talk to God about that. But staying bitter will not help you to overcome, will not help you to be better. In Romans, the word commands us, Romans 12:21, do not be overcome by evil, but overcome evil with good. It's so easy to let those things bring us down. It's so easy. Let me not say it's easy. It feels easy. Right? I've been in that spot. It would feel so easy to just give up right now. It would feel so easy to just walk away, run away, go somewhere where nobody knows me, and just do my own thing. I'll admit, sometimes that sounds really good. But that's not how we overcome the world. That's not how we become the people of God. That's not how we become part of His kingdom. That's not how we overcome. We overcome with good. Translations can add emphasis to what we read. In the much of the original New Testament transcripts were written in Greek. That was the language of the educated of that time. And the Greek word for overcome used here is nikeo, and it means to mightily prevail over, to master, to be victorious, not just to muddle through, right? Not just to barely squeeze out of it, but to mightily prevail. Let's be honest, man. How many times are we in these situations and we're weak because we make ourselves weak? We got to understand who God is. God is not the person that helps us squeak through our little issues. God is the Almighty. God is the creator of heaven and earth. God is the Lord of Lords and King of Kings, and He's not there to barely win. He is there to help us to mightily prevail. He's there for us to claim a decisive victory. Right? This thing ain't going into overtime, folks. When He comes, every knee will bow and every tongue will confess. Victory. Absolute. Let me skip down here. So it's We need to praise God. We need to acknowledge God for who He is and all He is and all He does and is capable of doing, which is everything, hands down. Romans 8:37 says, "No, in all these things we are more than conquerors through Him who loved us." More than conquerors. In 1 Corinthians it says, "But thanks be to God, He gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, stand firm. Let nothing move you. Always give yourselves fully to the work of the Lord, because you know that your labor in the Lord is not vain." Stand firm and let nothing move you. Right? Give yourselves fully. Be all in. Trust. Just do that. Here's what Jesus describes that the church should look like. He says, it's in Matthew 16:18. It says, "And I tell you that you are Peter, and on this rock I will build my church. And the gates of Hades, the gates of hell, will not overcome it." Like Peter, man, we need to be the rock. Also, like Peter, man, we have our faults, right? He didn't pick Peter because he was all in and dedicated and doing everything right. But he saw in Peter, and he created in Peter, that ability to be a rock that the church would be planted on, right? And today, he calls us to do the same thing. He's not done planting his church. Right, and we're those rocks that he's going to plant that church on if we just trust him, if we only follow him, if we'll only be all in. Right? Believe me, look, we all want to live a great life. We all want to have great stuff. We all want to be successful, right? But the real reason God created us was to build his kingdom. The real reason that God has called us is to spread his good news that God so loved the world. Right? The church is not inside this building. We are the church. And when he talks about building the church, he's not talking about building a building. He's talking about all of his people that he's called together to join together to be his kingdom here on earth, just like it will be in heaven. Amen. When we move with the Lord, we will be more than conquerors, right? And if you guys have been with us for a while, you'll know one of my heroes in the Bible was David, right? So I want to read this verse from David because David says it best. This is when he's getting ready to fight Goliath. David said to the Philistine, to Goliath, "You come against me with sword and spear and javelin, but I come against you in the name of the Lord Almighty, the God of the armies of Israel, whom you have defied. This day the Lord will deliver you into my hands, and I'll strike you down and cut off your head. This very day I will give the carcasses of the Philistine army to the birds and the wild animals, and the whole world will know that there is a God in Israel. All those gathered here will know that it is not by sword or spear that the Lord saves, for the battle is the Lord's, and he will give all of you into our hands. Imagine this boy, because that's all he was. Imagine this boy standing in the field and this mighty giant standing against him, and the whole army of the Philistines standing behind him, and he says, I'm going to cut off your head. And I'm going to feed the carcasses of all these dudes with you to the birds. Right? But hear what he says, man. Because they're looking at him from the world view and saying, that's never going to happen, man. But he says, it's not by me. It's not in my power that this is going to happen. God is going to do this. And when he does, you're going to know he's God. Man, get to know Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. I promise you, if you will really get to know him, if you will really be all in, you will see God, you will hear God, and you will know who God is. God is the Almighty. If you don't know Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior today, I pray that you would take the opportunity to do so. I pray that you would ask Jesus Christ to be your Lord and Savior, that you would begin that journey, that you would begin to overcome the things of this world, that you would begin to join us in the battle for the kingdom. And what a great battle it is, because it's already been won. All you have to do is trust Jesus as your Lord and Savior. Today could be your day of salvation. Pray with me. Lord, thank you for who you are and all you do. Thank you that you are the Almighty, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the Creator of heaven and earth and everything in it. And thank you that we can humbly come to you as just such small, insignificant creatures, and that you could use us in your mighty and powerful plan. Lord, I know it's your will that none should perish. I pray that you would strengthen us, that you would build us up, that we would feel your presence, that we would hear your voice, that we would come together to spread your gospel, to spread the good news that God so loved the world. Lord, and I pray if there's anyone here who doesn't know Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior, that right now, Lord, as we pray, that they would just acknowledge that they can't do it on their own, that they can't save themselves, but that they know and acknowledge the one who can save them, Jesus Christ. Lord, I thank you for all those that are here, all those that have accepted Jesus, and all those that are still here seeking, Lord. I pray that they would continue to come and continue to hear your message. And Lord, we'll be careful as we go out here. Lord, I just pray for this wedding today. We thank you for this beautiful weather. We thank you for this dedication that we did this morning, Lord. We thank you for all the great things and the wonderful things that you bring to us. And Lord, I pray that in everything we say and everything that we do, we'll give you the praise and all the glory. In Jesus' precious name. And everyone said, amen.
Wow. So I'd like to reiterate what Paul prayed about before our service. Something's moving here. I have no idea what happened with the amp, but we made it through that. It just seems like one thing after another, Satan just fighting. I look over at Scott, and there's a broken string a couple times, or I've broken strings. So we just really appreciate your prayers. Who I was praying once we had that issue. Thanks to our tech team, Snake, Art, and Brian. Special thanks to Brian, fellow guitar player, coming up here helping that. God, I'm just glad that you're my savior. And where's Lisa Fuller? Let's play some blues.
Whisper on the screen, you have everything. Always got my back.
God. Have a great week.